Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. With this video, I'm going to show you how you can create animated text or doodle to use on CapCut for your videos. Now let's get started. First, we need an app that we can write out the text or draw the doodle. Personally, I like to use Procreate, but that's only available on the Apple device. I know most of my viewers are Android users. So with this video, I'm going to show you how to do that on PicsArt, which is available on both Android and Apple device. Open the PicsArt app after you download it. Click on the plus icon. Then you will scroll all the way down to the bottom. First, I'm going to show you how you can create your doodle or text as a sticker, which means it will have a transparent background, and add animation to it later on CapCut. So to do that, we will select the transparent background one. If you need specific size for your doodle, you can click on fit. Then make sure the transparent background one is on. Then go to ratio. Then you can select the ratio that would work for your video. For YouTube video, you can select 16:9. Click on apply after you are done. So now it's ready for you to draw any doodle or text that you want. There are two different ways that you can do it. The first one is to click on the draw icon. Then you can click on the brush. You can select any brush that you like. And once you're happy with it, then you click on the check mark. Then go to the color palette icon. You can select whichever color that you like. Then you can draw the doodle that you like. After you are done, you can click on the three dot, then click on save image. So pretty much that's how you can draw any doodle that you like or write out any text that you want to use. You can even use the text function they have, because I know some of the font might not be available on CapCut, so you can also use this method to do it. I'm going to show you another way on how you can create a doodle. So I'm going to click on cancel and discard this one. So it would return back to the transparent background. So you would scroll your icon to the left, then click on brushes. As you can see here, the different brush that you can use. So the first one is just solid color. You can click on the icon again to adjust the size or opacity. Click on undo if you don't like it. This is the second type. Third type, which has a glow effect to it. The fourth one, it has a lot of preset, so you can click on this icon here to adjust the size if you want. Select whichever one you like, and you can start decorating. There are many different ones that you can select. Once you're happy with it, you can click on apply and click on save. So that's another fun way that you can do it. Now I'm going to click on undo to remove it. There's one more way that you can decorate, which is to click on sticker. You can search whatever you like. For example, let's do snowman. Then you can see things that relate to snowman will pop up here. The one with cloud icon is the one that you have to get subscription for, but the one with owl, you can use it for free. So you can select whichever one you like. Then you can adjust the size to how you like. You can even rotate it or flip it if you like. Then put it at a place that you are happy with it. I used this method for a lot of my loading screen before. So after you're done, you can click on apply. Then you can save the image. So those are the ways that you can create doodle or use sticker to decorate your video. Now let me show you how to create the animated text. I'm just go back to it. So to create animated text, we need a background for it. Here's the formula I use. For black text, I would use white background. For white text, I would use black background. For color text, I would use white background or green background, as long as the color is not green or similar color to it. You can also try to use color text with black background. But personally, I think white background or green background is better. In this example, I'm going to show you how to create white text with black background, but the process would be the same for other color. So I'm going to click on the black background. Usually you don't really need a specific size for the animated text, but if you're drawing out in a specific way, for example, you want it to have it across your video, then you want to go to fit and select the ratio you want. In this example, I'm going to do the 16 to 9 again. As you can see, that's a white background to it. So make sure you click on color and select the black background to match the one we select before. If size doesn't really matter to you, you can skip this step. Click on apply. Then we will go to draw again. Then you can click on brush. Usually I just select the first one. Make sure your opacity is 100%. Personally, I found it doesn't work well when you have transparent background text or glowing effect text. So just make sure you select a brush that has solid color to it. After you're done, then click on the check mark. Go to the color palette. For black background, we will select white color for the text. Now click on the camera icon, which means anything you draw on this canvas, it will be recorded. Your goal is to write out your text in one take. If you don't like it, you can always undo all the way. Repeat that process again till you are happy with the text that you write. After you are done, you can click on the camera icon again. Click on export video. You can adjust this line here to make the speed faster or slower. You can always adjust the speed on CapCut later as well. So click on done, then click on save photos. So that's how you can create the animated text with this method. Let's say it's hard for you to write out the text or draw the doodle on a tiny screen. There's another way that you can do it, which is to write out the text or draw the doodle on a piece of white paper. So these are the text that I wrote out on a piece of white paper. The lighting wasn't really good, so I'm going to make some adjustment to it. Your goal is to have the white paper part really white. If you have iPhone, you can just click on edit. For Android device, I'm not sure how that works, but you can easily use any photo editing app to make some adjustment to it. I'm going to increase some exposure to it. As you can see, it made the background more white. I'm going to also adjust the highlight. For contrast, I'm also going to increase it as well. Once I'm happy with it, I'm going to cut out the part that I want. So this part. Now we have this ready to use on CapCut. You can use black marker or color marker for this. You might wonder, is there any way that I can use white text instead? Well, you can use a black paper and white marker if you can find it, but I know a lot of people probably don't have it. So we can make some adjustment to the picture. So we will open PicsArt again. This time we are going to click on all photos. Get to the photo that we just made edit. Then click on effects. Then you will scroll all the way down till you see colors. Then you go to select negative. So now it turned the text from black color to white color, and then white background to black background. And then you just click here to save. Now let's go use them on CapCut. As you can see here, I have import different example of the animated text as an overlay. In order to remove black or white background, make sure you would import it as an overlay. Otherwise, it will not work. Now let's start with the one that I created earlier. So as you can see, I don't like the first part, so I'm going to make some adjustment to it. So I'm going to click on here, split, and then click on the part I don't want, delete, and move it back to the beginning. To remove black background, you can click on the clip, click on splice, then you can select filter or lighten. For black text, white background, you can also click on splice. You would click on slide for it. For color text with black background, you can also use the splice function. I'm going to make it bigger so you can see. So click on splice. Then you can click on lighten. However, with this method, it might lighten the text a little. So if you don't mind that as much, then you can use this. But this will not work well if you use the Chroma key. So I'm going to click on the Chroma key so you can see the difference. Select the black color and then adjust the intensity. As you can see, there are still some not smooth black color on the outline of the text, which I don't think you would like, but if you do like this type, feel free to use it. But in this case, I think splice function would be better. For green screen or white screen with color text, you can use Chroma key. So click on the clip, then click on Chroma key and select the color that you want to remove. I'm not sure why it's not selecting the right color, so I'm going to move this out a little so it's on its own. Click on it again, then click on Chroma key, select the green color, adjust the intensity to remove it. You will do the same thing with the white background one. Chroma key, remove the white color. So that's how you can use the splice function or Chroma key to remove the background. Then you can adjust the text to where you like. You can also adjust the speed to be faster or slower. For the text we draw on the paper, you just use the same method. Click on splice, then click on lighten. You can also add in some animation to it if you want. With picture, you only can use one animation to it, but you can split it into two. This way, you also can use another animation for the second part. We also create some doodle as a sticker. Now, I'm going to show you how to use them. So you would click on stickers, click on the picture icon, then you just select the one that we just made. You can make adjustment to it to how long you want it to be. Then move it to the place that you like. You can also make another copy of it and readjust the size if you want. Then you can click on the sticker again, select animation. Then you can select whichever animation you like. Personally, I like to use loop animation because the animation will continue throughout that timeline of the sticker. I like to use wobble and adjust the speed to however you like. And you just do the same thing with the other one. Select any animation that you like. Let's add in the other sticker that we created earlier. Add in animation if you want. Then adjust it to the part that you want. So that's how you can create the animated text or doodle to use on CapCut for your video. If you found my video to be helpful, please consider like and subscribe and comment down below because that would really help more people to see my video. If you watch till here, please comment down below with a heart emoji to let me know. Happy holidays to those who celebrate. As always, I hope you have a wonderful day and I will see you next time.